CBS Sports coverage of the road to the Final Four brings you to Chrysler Arena, Ann Arbor, Michigan, the Spartans and the Wolverines, an in-state rivalry. Starting lineups on what would be a senior day, if there were some at Michigan, include a lot of freshmen. For the Wolverines, Morris leading the way with Hardaway Jr., Novak, Douglas, and Morgan. Senior Laden, Michigan State, led by former Big Ten Player of the Year, Kalen Lucas, Keebler, Summers, Green, and Garrick Sherman for the Spartans. Our officials for today's game, anchored by the veteran Ted Valentine, John Yorkovich, and Terry Weimer. Tim Brando alongside the G-Man, Mike Jaminski. And we're set for this final game of the regular season. We put a period on one third of the year after today, and the opening tap is controlled to Sparty.
Michigan looking to sweep this series for the first time since 1997 with that big win at Michigan State earlier this year.
Came at a time when Michigan had a record of 1-6 in conference play. And boy, have they improved. A chance to finish 9-9 in the league with a win today. And that's the same record they had when they made the tournament, the NCAA tournament, a couple of years back. Shot clock under 5. Sherman took steps.
Well, this is one of the things that Tom Izzo wanted, to get some more post touches, but that got a little bit too late in the shot clock.
He'd love to keep his streak alive at 14 consecutive trips to the NCAAs with an at-large bid. And while Michigan State's in good shape, you would think, based on strength of schedule and RPI, they could take a lot of heat off going into the Big Ten tournament with a victory today.
This is one thing. Michigan will run the basketball, but 10 in the half court, they really like to grind it out, use a lot of shot clock.
Hardaway off the back rim. Summers gets 3-3 on 2. Leaves it for Lucas. Good defensive recognition by Michigan to get back, as the Spartans did have numbers. Lucas leaves it for Summers. He has really been struggling with his shot the last month.
For Michigan State to go anywhere, Summers has to start shooting the ball well.
There's the tip in by the freshman Jordan Morgan.
We talked about it. Long jump shot, start a fast break, and Michigan will run out when they have the opportunity. Good follow by Morgan.
Wolverines decided to go with the home gold, the same uniforms that they wore on the road when they got that win and ended that long Spartan winning streak at the Breslin Center. Green taking it inside is fouled as Zach Novak came over to give a little bit of help. As did Jordan Morgan. I think they tagged Morgan with the foul.
Number 52, Jordan Morgan.
Here are the standings, Mike, and you can see how important this game would be, particularly for Michigan.
Top three are all set: Ohio State, Purdue, Wisconsin. But that's that middle three that there's going to be some juggling and some nervous palms going into the Big Ten tournament. Michigan State, Illinois, and Michigan. Penn State with a very, very outside chance.
If you look at this Michigan State team and what they've been through with the defections, all of the attrition that Tom Izzo's gone through, this has been the ringleader for this club.
Well, and I want to stretch it a little bit, but a little like Magic Johnson, yep, in that he's the heart and soul of the team. He's big. He leads them in assists and rebounds. Very much the conscience of his team, and he's helping together. He's coming off of a stomach illness, just getting back into shape.
Leads them in 4 statistical categories. That shot way off the mark by Morris. Look at that quick transition to offense by Lucas, but he comes up empty. Morgan gets the outlet. Once again, a hard drive by Morris. Boy, this kid's got a future. Sophomore from Windward High in Los Angeles, California.
Well, he went to John Beilein last year and said, I want the ball, and he's grown into that role, and all he's done to lead the Big Ten in assists this year.
Summers again grazing the iron.
I mean, that's as good a look as Summers is going to get defensively, and it would be so important for him to knock down a shot early to get some confidence.
State is 0 for 4 from the floor to open the game. Morgan, nice jump hook.
Now, offensively, they play 4-on-1, and they give Morgan a lot of room to operate. He'll set screens on the perimeter, but he gets some deep post-up position that time.
Already, Mike, he's got 4 points and 3 boards. Very active early. Draymond Green over Novak. Morgan clears it for Michigan.
That's going to be a key thing. They've got to make Michigan State miss and then clear the defensive boards.
Morris, a pull-up. Keebler comes down with it off the deck. Another one of the many seniors on this Michigan State team. And you wonder if that will serve them well once they get into the second season. Draymond Green from downtown off the back iron. And Keebler will be tagged with the foul going over the back.
Well, this kind of shows you both of their facets of their offense. And Darius Morris out on the open floor finishing with the left hand. And then the wide open spaces for Jordan Morgan to operate in the paint.
Multiple substitutions by Tom Izzo looking for some help after this 0-for-6 start. Adrian Payne has come onto the floor. Austin Thornton, number 13, is in the game. And Delvon Rowe, number 10 for the Spartans, all coming in off that timeout.
And this is an early lead for Michigan without having hit a three so far, which is...
Oh, what a rejection that was by Adrian Payne, but they're going to count the goal. Ball was on the downward flight.
Well, Tom Izzo was talking glowingly about Payne early before the game. And that's a good call, and you'll get that right in front of the rim. Morgan getting good position inside. But Payne, another guy coming back from injury, had a shoulder issues before the season started.
Appling. This is the freshman sensation, McDonald's All-America. Want more from him, and he's been delivering. Tom Izzo wants him to take more shots, especially with summer struggling. And there he is, right on cue. Too strong this time. Rowe, the offensive rebound.
Just played right over the top of Novak that time. Novak has got to block him out a little bit farther away from the rim.
Payne sets the pick for Lucas, who negotiates into the paint. Strong move. And they're going to call a charge, as you might expect it. The heart and soul of this team, Zach Novak, comes in to pick up the player control. Izzo doesn't like it. His team is 0-for-8 and down by 7 early. All right, Greg, quite a comeback there. No question about that. Down 15 just a few moments ago. Take a look at this. This could have been a no call, don't you think, Mike?
Well, this is one of the things with guarding Lucas, that you have to defend the pick and roll, but he got deep in. And then Novak is a guy who will step in and give up his body, and probably would have been served better to be a no call in that situation.
Foul difficulty, especially for Lucas, would be a problem. Technically, they're 0-for-7 because of the foul call. That shot did not count, but Izzo's just, and his team has struggled to score in the past. They need an early answer to this Michigan onslaught, as the building here has just been absolutely electric with this quality start for the Wolverines. Morris off the feed from Smotrich.
And he's got a size advantage over Lucas. A good post up that time. And Kalen Lucas going for the steal and coming up empty.
Evan Smotrich, and they're rooted in Massachusetts by way of New Hampton Prep, number 23 in gold, in the game for the Wolverines. Checking Adrian Payne, who's quickly doubled, and he took steps. The third turnover committed by Michigan. And a sarcastic smile from Izzo.
Well, you see right here, you get the post up and the seal, and Morris looking like a post player on that play. Nice entry pass, too.
All of these points, Mike, for Michigan coming in the paint. They've been able to get very close to the 10. Novak, he hit 6 threes in the first meeting. And the rebound cleared to Payne. Gets it into Kalen Lucas's hands. Thornton, way too strong. And the rebound by Morris.
No second chance points for Tim. When you're struggling offensively, you got to build out inside out.
Morris lost it that time. Forced it. Lucas looking for some help. The trailer is Thornton.
Good transition defense by Michigan to cover that breakup.
Douglas doing a nice job checking Lucas off the ball, isn't he? Another veteran player for this Michigan team. No seniors, but juniors. There's Appling. Not there. And foul spotted underneath. It will go against Smotrich. His first. And Draymond Green comes back on the floor, replacing Adrian Payne. And Michigan counters, going to their bench with Matt Vogrich, the sophomore from Lake Forest, Illinois, number 13. Lucas, finally,
The drought comes to an end from the floor, and better than 6 minutes until Michigan State scratches from the field.
Well, John Beilein hanging his head after that play, but you pitch a shutout for six plus minutes, you got to be happy with your defense.
Inside Smotrich. Count it and a foul.
What a terrific post-up move by Smotrich. You watch the head fake inside, and Delvon Rowe bites on it. He is one of the best defenders in the Big Ten. Smotrich with a chance for a three-point play. Outstanding post move.
He's really been consistent the last month of the season. This coming after losing his starting position. He started the first 24 games of the year, but this is a youngster that can score in a variety of ways. So the old-fashioned three-point play moves the lead to 10.
Had an 18-point game against Clemson earlier this year.
Lucas off the bounce. Air ball. And he's going to hear that from the student section. Two years removed from being the Big Ten Player of the Year.
Terrell Summers has gotten the only open jump shot I can remember in this game. That Michigan doing a great job of going out and challenging jump shots.
Smotrich again, and he's fouled inside. Novak again able to find him cutting to the basket, and Delvon Rowe picks up his second foul.
Well, when you got a driver and you're big and you're along the baseline, you get your hands ready and you become a receiver, and that's all that Smotrich did on that play, was ready to get the pass.
Well, don't forget to download the free CBS Sports mobile app and get live college basketball scores and stats. For more information, go to CBSSports.com. On your phone. This time of year, we've got to have our mobile apps, you and I. What would we do without them, right?
That's what I have the truck for, to tell me what's going on.
Michigan State to within 10. They went 6.5 minutes without scoring, and we welcome those of you joining us for game two of our triple hitter. The Spartans and the Wolverines engaged in an old-fashioned Big Ten rivalry. Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski.
I find it interesting that Michigan, they'll change defenses, but it's been mostly man-to-man in this game so far. Not a lot of zone.
Hardaway Jr. too strong, and Summers gets the rebound for the Spartans.
Maybe a little bit of a force on that jump shot. Tim Hardaway looking to get himself involved in the offense, has not had many touches.
Michigan State open this game 0 for 8 from the floor with 3 turnovers. Managed to maintain some contact with 1 field goal coming from Kalen Lucas. And Rowe has given them their second just as we came to you, the majority of our audience. And Summers takes it inside. That will be a block. Underneath the foul will go against Tim Hardaway Jr. Wolverines looking to dance and march. Back at Chrysler Arena, our score, Michigan 15-5 with the lead. Tim Brando, Mike Jaminski, and Mike, let's take a look at home court advantage presented by Buffalo Wild Wings. Obviously, with a young team, you're playing 6 freshmen. You'd rather be at home, wouldn't you?
No question about it, but this team has really grown over the course of the year and playing much better and much more maturely at this point of the season. Good start for them in a very critical game. Not to say that it's more critical for one than the other, but I think Michigan needs this win more than Michigan State does in the big picture.
Yeah, and John Beilein knows that. By the way, freshly becoming a granddad for the first time. Spoke with him earlier this week. I think he's very gratified, too, to see that this team has set a foundation for the long-term future. You know, he was a little ahead of the curve when they made the NCAAs a couple of seasons back. We had them when they lost to Oklahoma and Blake Griffin, a fine basketball team, but they didn't get what they needed out of Manny Harris and Deshaun Sims a year ago.
And he talked about it with me, and he talked about how much that Tommy Amaker had done to resurrect this program and give him the platform to continue to let it grow.
Amaker, of course, has done an outstanding job at Harvard since, over in the Ivy League.
Playing for a berth, I think, this weekend.
Maybe. That's right. And a foul spotted inside. It goes against Mike Keebler. That's his second. So this is not a deep Michigan State team by any stretch.
No, it's always a tough play to go left and finish right. But Morris using that big body, and I don't know that there's any player that's improved more from last year to this year is Darius Morris.
By the way, in mentioning what you did, Mike, that's one of the great debates in this year's NCAA tournament field. Could the Ivy League get two teams in? There's some conjecture about that.
I think it's a very good fit. He landed on his feet, and coaching at Harvard, obviously his experience at Duke, he's done a terrific job. He's owned Boston College over the last 3 years.
He has. Draymond Green gets it inside. Knicks, he's doubled. And the foul spotted against Michigan.
Well, and an unnecessary foul. And Michigan has been committed, and they come over low that time with Morris. But they have been committed to double teaming the post anytime a guy gets it in a touch inside.
Yeah, that left knee, according to John Yorkovich, was the problem for Morris. You see, Smotrich takes a seat, and Morgan back on the floor, number 52, the redshirt freshman from Detroit.
I think Draymond Green's got to find a way to take advantage. He's got a size advantage over Novak, and he's not been able to get anything in the post because of that double team.
Standard 1-3-1 turns to 2-3 from time to time for Michigan. Very difficult defense if you don't see much of it. And Darrell Summers finally off the schneid as he gets his first three ball of the day.
Well, they desperately need his offense, and Tim, I'll reiterate it. If they're going to go anywhere in the NCAA tournament, both he and Lucas have to be playing at a high level. They lost so many shooters from last year.
Absolutely. Morris. Boy, they are an unkind to him. He's 0 for 4. The rest of the team shooting relatively well here in the early going. A collective 6 of 9 for all of the other Wolverines. Off the ball. Foul spotted inside. Looks like they're going to tag Morgan with the foul. That's the second on Jordan. And John Beilein will go back to his bench. He'll call upon Blake McLinans, 6'10", 240-pounder from Hamburg, New York, from Wooster Academy. So Morgan leaves the game with 6 points, four boards, and a couple of fouls. He had been very effective, but now saddled in foul difficulty with two. And plenty of time remaining in the first half. And they tried to get Green more involved, as you'd expect, Mike. And here's Summers left free.
Unable to build on the confidence of that first made jump shot with
Douglas. You talk about a stable player. To go along with Novak, Stu Douglas has been asked to do so many things. A year ago, he had to play some point guard. There's McClymans just into the game, rattling it home, and it's 19-10.
He's already doubled his game average. Any points from him, like finding money in the sofa.
Novak nearly the steal. Appley decides to think better of going inside and give it back to Lucas. The crowd responds to the defensive effort.
No easy opportunity so far for Michigan State. Everything in the half court.
Well, Spartan's so good at spreading you. That foul will go against Douglas. Crowd doesn't like it. But that's what John Beilein teams are about, both offensively and defensively, extending the floor.
Well, there's a great job. You just go out, and Summers trying to do the right thing, getting to the rim. That time, Stu Douglas just a little late, but he and Novak both committed to taking charges on drivers.
It has been said that it takes a while for teams to mature and progress in Beilein's approach, both offensively and defensively. He was, this young team, he thinks, has proven that to be a myth. They have really gravitated well to his teachings, especially the second half of the year. Novak on the dribble drive. Douglas, he can hit that shot. He's got range, comes up just a bit short. Left that one crying on the front of the rim. Green, beautiful pass to Summers. That's what the point forward can do.
And it all starts with Sherman in the back screen at the top. Well-conceived play.
After the sluggish start, Michigan State beginning to pick it up on the offensive end, trailing by 7. Douglas on a baseline blow by with a poor pass. Snared by the freshman Applin.
That's where Michigan State needs to be, Tim. They are so good in transition and out on the open floor. They've not been successful in the half court in this game. Make your defense, create some offense.
Some of the Spartan fans making a little noise now. On an 11-4 run, the Spartans, they've cut the lead down to 5. And let's take a look at our Applebee's neighborhood favorites in the 89 championship game. Michigan led by Steve Fisher in that controversial call by John Clockerty. But they were able to beat the Big East upstart Seton Hall. P.J. Carlissimo's team 80-79. With just 3 seconds remaining, it proved to be the difference as the Wolverines won their first national championship.
Hey, you forget that P.J. Carlissimo had gotten Seton Hall all the way to the national championship game. Glenn Rice right there, his son now playing for Georgia Tech. But what an outstanding run to the championship they had with Steve Fisher.
One of the most remarkable national semifinals, too, with Lou Henson's Flying Illini meeting for the third time that Michigan team. And Michigan prevailed for the first time that season at the most important time.
With apologies to our colleague Stephen Bardo, and loves to be reminded of that, as I do of Kentucky.
It does happen, doesn't it? There you see the youngster Morris, who has struggled with his shot a bit, and John Beilein trying to settle him down. A little tough love from the head coach of Michigan. John Clockerty, by the way, who made that controversial call, is now the supervisor of officials for the ACC. Hendricks, that was a tough pass. A little miscommunication, and we've got a timeout. 7:35 remaining, opening half. Wolverines by 5. Take a look at our game summary. It's been a game of runs, a 15-3 run to open it, 11-4 response from Michigan State, Mike Jaminski, and really the ability to get close to the 10. That's been the difference for Michigan.
Well, I think the big thing, Tim, is that for Michigan State to be able to go out and get out on the open floor, their half-court offense and shooting has not been good, but they've gotten some turnovers here lately, and then it's been Michigan inside that has been most effective in this game. And the thing is, I think that Michigan State is really committed to defending the 3 in this game, so Michigan State taking what the defense gives them, they're getting great post position inside and really dominating that area of the game so far.
Morgan, who does have a good start underway, is forced to the bench because of the foul difficulty, but now coming out of the timeout, John Beilein, understanding the advantage that Morgan, the freshman, has given him, has decided to roll the dice and go with him with 7:35 remaining in the half. Colton Christian has also come into the game for the first time, number 45, another freshman from Bellevue, Washington, for the Wolverines.
I think with Morgan, you could take a chance guarding against Nix, who may not be that active in the post.
And Christian has some fouls to give and gives one now to Draymond Green. Evan Smotrich will come back into the game for Morgan. So you can see that Beilein wants to massage minutes here for Morgan, using him on the offensive end, but not necessarily defensively. Hardaway Jr. comes down with a rebound.
Well, I think the thing with Green, he's such a unique player, Tim, that he's one of the 3 guys in the country leading his team in rebounds and assists, which is just a combination you don't see all that much.
Holbridge, pretty good passer, gives it up to Smotrich. You mentioned he can face up, has a perimeter game. There's a beautiful tap out. And does so.
Yeah, and that's how many times you see you get a good look. 40% shooter from 3, but after an offensive rebound and the tap out, the defense is scattered. Nobody identified him.
Summers dumping it down to Draymond Green. Well, his ability to throw the skip pass is just amazing. From the baseline, reading a double. Appling gives it back to him, and Draymond decides to launch. Not there.
And not only is Michigan double-teaming the post well, but they're recovering out of it and challenging shooters.
Well, Darius Morris struggling with his game a bit, seeing some time along the bench, and they're asking Hardaway Jr. now to handle the ball a bit more, as well as Stu Douglas, who can also hit from the perimeter. Summers gets the rebound.
And let's see if Michigan can get Hardaway involved. He's really struggled offensively to this point in the game, and he really wasn't much of a factor in the win up in East Lansing, but for him to get going, I think it's going to be a big key.
And Novak carried the day at the Breslin Center, and as Appling takes it inside, he's fouled.
So here's the look. If you can't get the offensive rebound, just bat it outside, and you can see the, and that was just a lapse also defensively. You never leave the guy with the basketball.
Bolton Christian got the foul. He checks out of the game, so he's in for about a minute, picks up two, and Appling is at the free throw line. Freshman from Pershing High School in nearby Detroit. Tomorrow on CBS, The Amazing Race is in Japan, where the team slip, slide, and take aim to stay in the game. A new Amazing Race tomorrow, only CBS.
And they're hoping that Keith Appling had that breakout game against Iowa last time, 18 points. They've been after him to be more aggressive and looking for his offense. He's deferred to people up to this point, and they need his scoring.
And before that game, Tom Izzo took him aside and said, hey, you know, we're here at Breslin Center. Didn't he score 49 in the state championship game here and break Antoine Joubert's Michigan High School record? He said, I want you to remember that tonight.
Yeah, but I think the comp is a little better on this level. That's just a guess.
Yeah. Vogrich. Fans wanted a foul on Lucas from beyond the arc. They didn't get it. Appling is on the loose. This enables Kalen Lucas to play off the ball when they move Appling to the point. See if he can get free.
Well, good read that time. The double came from the baseline. How many times, Tim, have we seen Green look cross court to find that shooter in the baseline?
Well, the old guard that Tom Izzo is, Mike, it's amazing how many mix and match guards he's had through the years. Lucas and Allen, when they were together, there's Novak answering with a three of his own.
Well, that's a lapse. I mean, if there's one guy you can't leave open, it's Novak. Talked about it, burned him with six threes in the first game, and now where the three-point shot was not a part of their offense in the first 10 minutes of this half, they've done a lot of it here lately.
25-19, a six-point Wolverines lead. Appling. Rebound by Vogrich. Gets it to Morris, who's back in the game. He finds Novak. Ooh, he designed that one for the window, but it did not go down. He is an old school player, isn't he, Mike?
Yeah, and just gets so much. I mean, here's a guy at his size, 6'4". He's 11th in the conference in rebounding, Tim. Does so much for them besides shoot the three.
He told me that Zach told me that in that game against Michigan State, as you see the steal, Smatrich on the open floor. It's the lay-in. Novak said it was the best game he had had shooting since he had come to Michigan, since the game he had with Duke in his freshman year. Wolverines back up by eight.
And that was just a poor decision by Kalen Lucas, a senior. You expect a better choice out of that, but that turnover leading directly to a layup.
Hardaway comes in a little too closely and picks up the ball. They're going to tag Lucas instead? I'm not sure.
Now, Lucas getting the foul that time.
He
kind of raked the ball through with his elbows, and Rice caught it right in the face.
Yeah, and I think they're going to take a look at it because the elbow did go to the face. They'll check the monitor while we're away. There you see Tim Hardaway Jr. He took one to the chops from Kalen Lucas, and they looked at the monitor to determine if they want to or feel the need to call a technical, and they were just speaking the official's word to Tom Izzo and informing him as to the decision. A point of emphasis, Mike, has been given to any blow by the elbow above the chin.
An intentional foul, and And they are calling an intentional.
They're calling an intentional foul. And Lucas, and it's a basketball play where if you're getting pressured, you have to rip the ball through the defender. But you, if you do it as high as he did and you leave with your elbows, that's going to be called a, that's going to be called an intentional foul. And if it's, if there was intent behind it, or if it's a technical foul, and if there's intent behind it, then an intentional foul.
Right, right. And again, it may seem to be a little harsh, but this was a part of a conference call about a month ago that all Big Ten officials had. In fact, it came into play in a game that Bill Raftery and I had at Northwestern against Illinois. And I think especially with the concerns to concussions and symptoms similar to concussions, it's been a hot button issue among officials around the country this season.
And for the most part, in games that we've seen, the calls have been pretty consistent. That's Kalen Lucas's second foul.
He was obviously surprised, as was Tom Izzo, but you have to live with that, with the understanding that there was no malice intended, but that the blow was delivered above the chin. So that's the second foul on Lucas, which is important. He cannot pick up a cheap one here in the remaining three and change that we have in the first half. And it serves as yet another turnover. And the Wolverines leading by eight. I think that's what Kalen's trying to explain to John Yurkovich, that it was a basketball move. There was no malice intended by the veteran and former Big Ten Player of the Year. Tom's not particularly happy, but I think he's having to.
Well, now the thing is, because Rice can't shoot the free throws, it's going to be him that's going to pick out the free throw shooter.
So it should be a free throw and then the ball for Michigan. And obviously the decision's now being determined, as you mentioned, Mike, who will take that free throw, who will come in and shoot it.
And right now, this is taking an inordinately a long period of time to get this all sorted out.
Yeah, the level of political correctness on the part of the officials with the coaches, I think, has forced us to endure a longer than usual stoppage in play.
And stepping to the line now,
Zach Novak will step to the free throw line.
Number zero, Zach Novak.
First sophomore to ever be named a captain here at Michigan. And obviously he and Douglas co-captains this year.
Brian, an intentional foul, it was John Beilein's decision, which is why he puts an 85% shooter there.
Yeah. Should mention too that they were in the bonus at that stage as well, so the lead is back to 10, plus
possession, now goes to Michigan.
Possession goes to Michigan. Darius Morris, who has struggled early, as has Hardaway. When you think about it, it's been a quality half for all the rest of the Wolverines with the two youngsters in the backcourt, Hardaway and Morris, not having a good first half. Still Michigan leading by 10. Morris working on Apley. Trying to post him up as a taller guard, and he does get to the free throw line after the foul against the freshman Apley.
Well, that's the thing. If you look at the backcourt for Michigan State, both Lucas and Appling undersized. So good job of identifying that and getting your guards inverted. But I've always felt that this offense with John Beilein is better as a front runner, Tim. But when they're ahead, they spread you out, they make you chase, and it opens up back doors.
Coming up on AT&T at the half, our busy crew of Greg Gumbel, Greg Anthony, and Seth Davis will have all the scores and highlights, the latest NCAA tournament news, plus an Naismith watch presented by AT&T. That's all coming up on AT&T at the half. Well, Morris, after that really tough start, has now come in and scored eight. And it's 31-19. And in this game of runs, Michigan in the midst of a 9-0 spurt. Raymond Green just able to save that loose ball. Eric Sherman back in the game.
Well, and the bigs, they're really showing out on the screen roll action with Lucas and staying with him on a counter or two extra. They're not even worried about the roll guy.
Shot clock under 10, and Appling lost it. Smatrich all the way to the right.
33-19, game's largest lead. Timeout, Michigan State. An 11-0 run as the freshman Appling lost it, and Smotrich did the smart thing. And the Spartans turn it over yet again here.
You see that hard stay right there, and the good reach behind by Smotrich gets the deflection off the guard. Good finish out on the open floor. That's what Michigan State has had too little of this game, Tim, turning turnovers into points.
Yeah, and when you think about it, the Spartans in their last three trips, Mike, have turned it over, and the Wolverines have made good on each of them.
Their half-court offense has been very dodgy in this game.
Green left three up top. Sherman gets the recycle with the offensive rebound, feeds Lucas. Two good looks by their two best players, and they come up empty.
And one of the few offensive rebounds that Michigan State has had in this game. Michigan doing a nice job of sealing it, keeping them to one shot.
Nice ball fake by Smotrich. Sherman collects the rebound. Spartans really need to get something done to cut this under double digits before the break. A lot of empty trips in the last 5 minutes. On the wing, Appling says, "Thank you, I'll do the honors," and it's 33-22.
Pretty nice, and that's the thing that as Kalen Lucas gets back into condition, he's better defensively and he's better at creating those open opportunities for his teammates.
First points in almost 4 minutes for Michigan State. One thing that Izzo's defense has done, and they've kept Novak out of the scoring column. Morris will take the three, and it's not there. But Zach has the 1-3, and that's it. He lit him up in the first game, Mike, as you mentioned.
Well, I don't know about in that situation with Morris. If you want to settle for that at the end of the shot clock, you want to try to use that screen and get into the lane.
Appling feeds Sherman. Good pass to Summers on the wing.
That has been the reliable pass in their offense. They hit the post and look opposite along the baseline.
Just a moment ago, they were down 14. Those two trips have enabled them to cut it to 8, and Durrell now has 10. So he may be getting his wake-up call here in the first half. Michigan will hold it for the last shot of the half. Vogrich lost it. Draymond Green comes out of there with it, with time. And we're at the break. So the last 5 points go to the Spartans. They trail by 8. And we'll send you to Greg Gumbel with AT&T at the half right after these messages. You're watching CBS Sports on our 30th road to the Final Four. Feels better than he's ever felt. He told me that prior to the start of the game. He's missed some open looks by just a short margin, either right on the front of the rim or on the back iron. We'll see if some of those shots fall here in the second half. Novak does have the 1-3, and he's fouled from beyond the arc by Draymond Green, and that means 3 free throws coming to the junior captain.
And let's see, and now Zach Novak on the follow through. He's shaking his hand right now. See if it got affected. Looks like he's jammed the pointer finger on the follow through.
Oh, yeah. Good catch on your part.
And let's see now, too, if in the first 4 minutes, Tim, if they can get Tim Hardaway Jr. involved here in this offense.
You almost went Glenn Rice, didn't
almost,
you?
Almost. I was looking up his jersey.
Glenn's son, of course, is playing at Georgia Tech. There he is. Boy, what amazing games he had in this building. Talk about an automatic shot. He had it. You saw plenty of it.
Well, and apparently that and Novak's still shaking his hand off a little bit, but perfect on the first two.
Actually got two of the three, and it's now a 35-25 Michigan lead. Nobody came over to help Novak that time.
Yeah, I mean, that guy is just a ball player. He does so many things well on the floor, and the one thing you underestimate him is his ability to put it on the deck and get to the rim.
High pick and roll. Morgan wanted it from Hardaway, did not get it. And Hardaway comes up empty trying to use the window. He's 0 for 4 from the floor.
But I like the attitude, Tim. He's got that size advantage.
Oh, nice pass.
Green trying to stay with it. Boy, he did everything but finish. Appling with a good dish.
Well, you can see he's coming off a sprained ankle, too, and Draymond Green just doesn't have any lift.
And I think he's going to pick up that foul as well. His second, both of them coming here in the opening minute plus of the second half.
Well, you can see, I mean, he's got the whole side of the floor, and everybody's occupied defensively over here. He'll set the screen, get up top, look at this, and it'll just clear out.
Finally, Hardaway gets it done. 38 to 27, the lead is 11.
The end of a scoring drought is one shot away for a lot of these guys, and Hardaway has really been playing at a high level recently.
Green. Mr. Chippy, but Derek Sherman is there to tip it through.
Derek Sherman.
38 to 29. Delvon Roe will come in on the next dead ball. I think Green is laboring just a bit.
Now, and you can see that Michigan really battled Michigan State on the boards in the first half. Six offensive rebounds, but only 4 points as a result.
Not there for Hardaway this time. Lucas gets free.
Bit of a forced shot with Lucas right in front of him.
Green. Yeah, he's fatigued. Both the ankles part of the problem. Look at him. He still makes a defensive play with those hands, causing the turnover. Now an overrule. Teddy Valentine comes over and says, no, last touch by Delvon Roe. Green's going to sit down. He was asking to come out of the game. Yeah, and it was the toe right there of Lucas, apparently, that was the last to touch it. Novak past Roe is rejected by Delvon, and it's out of bounds to Michigan State. Good defensive sequence.
Well, Roe is a terrific defensive player, and it shows his flexibility to be able to go out on the perimeter and get a guard and then get the block at the end of the play.
Kalen Lucas operating at the point. Appling along with Delvon Roe, Garrett Sherman, and Darrell Summers, the five on the floor for Sparty. Off the ball fake, Summers. Roe the offensive rebound. Lucas pulls up. And it's out of bounds to Michigan. Kalen is 1 for 6, Mike, and you can see the frustration on his face. Senior that is just beginning to gain traction. We were there in round two when he had that ruptured Achilles tendon.
And you can see his scoring has gone up every month, and he's been on a tear lately, just under 20 points a game in February and early March. He had 27 in the losing effort at home, but clearly off his game right now. They've done a nice job again defending him in the screen roll.
Morgan, nice little drop step to get past Sherman, but he could not convert.
Neither team doing a good job in this half of finishing near the rim.
Off the curl, Lucas. Again, a quality look, just off the mark today.
And it's Tom Izzo looking for some combinations, and they had some good success with Appling and Lucas playing together in the backcourt.
Michigan State, 2 of 8 this half from the floor. Morris alley-ooping Hardaway. Count it.
Terrific screen by Morgan, too. They really had the whole lane emptied out, and that's what this offense features with Morgan. He'll pull out, and they'll open up passing lanes.
You really get a sense as we open the second half, Mike, what's at stake for the Wolverines. They need this game really more than Michigan State does. Lucas with a runner in the paint to answer, and it's 40 to 31. Morris going crossover. How strong was he with the ball to get that on the lid after being well defended?
He is the future of this Michigan program in so many respects.
Well, Novak and Rowe get tied up. Out of bounds. It belongs to Michigan. Wolverines with so much at stake. They want to punch a ticket to the NCAA tournament. Why not sky high to make the NCAAs? Oh, the bank was open late for Josh Gasser. This three-pointer for Wisconsin, you got to call those, was devastating to Michigan. And the reason why is when you look at the RPI, the results against top 50 teams, that could have been a game that would have catapulted Michigan to within the bubble. And I think it makes this game all the more important for the Wolverines against Michigan State.
Well, and the irony is that Michigan State beat Wisconsin under similar circumstances, and it was a guy, Corey Lucius, who's no longer with the team.
That's right.
That facilitated that win. So those Wisconsin wins and losses could be play a major role for these teams. But since the win in Michigan State, and Michigan has won 7 of 10, that was the catalyst for their season.
No doubt about it. They really turned it on. I talked to John Beilein. He said, you know, they had a loss to Minnesota that they felt like they should not have had before that victory. And he said they played with a sense of purpose after that.
Oh, Tim Hardaway starting to catch a little fire. He got that lob dunk and seeing a bigger basket now. 3 of 5 in this half.
Oh, the iron suddenly kind, and it's 42-31. He has 7 all this half. And the same for Lucas as he rattles it home, 42-33.
Yeah, great players come alive, and they have the ability to shed a poor half. And Kalen Lucas is going to be a factor in this game.
Hardaway off the bounce.
You see a little different body language for Tim Hardaway so far.
He's been the Big Ten Freshman of the Week 4 times. They might as well give him a statue for that award. He's had it so many times this season. High pick and roll, but Nick's unable to get free. Roll in traffic. That's a block. It'll go against Morgan, and if so, that's his third.
You know, Tim, for the pick and roll to be effective, the roll guy has got to be some sort of factor, and that's Michigan State has gotten nothing out of it. The bigs for Michigan are staying with it, a count or two or three longer with Lucas, and there's nobody else stepping up and scoring.
Junior from Euclid, Ohio, I beg your pardon, Delvon Rowe. Don't forget Wednesday on CBS, Tracking a Serial Sniper becomes a deadly game on an all-new Criminal Minds, Suspect Behavior. Forrest Whitaker stars Wednesday, only CBS. Originally went to play baseball, left-handed pitcher that could throw it at about a 90-mile-an-hour clip. Turned to basketball, and there's a reach-in foul off the missed free throw against Austin Thornton. Well, it's just Heartbreak Hotel for Tom Izzo. Struggling as it points, even the freebies. Knicks takes a seat, and Draymond Green back on the floor for Michigan State.
Tom Izzo talking about Derek Nix, and he says he has trouble with his weight and conditioning. He just can't play for long stretches.
Well, you know Hardaway wants to put it up, but Appling not giving him any room, and it leads to a turnover. Lucas, end-to-end, fouled by Novak. You and I were trying to think of a player that Novak would remind us of, and there are a couple of examples that came to our minds as he comes back here defensively.
Yeah, running back, and I thought of Chris Kramer, who played for Purdue in the last few years. Novak more gifted offensively, but same kind of that undersized, gritty guy, just under 6 rebounds.
Remember back in 2006 when Bruce Pearl got Tennessee to the Sweet 16 for the first time, he had a kid by the name of Dane Bradshaw.
Yeah.
Who sat at the end of the bench before Pearl got there. He turned him into a power forward that could find openings and cracks with interior passes, and he got much the same out of him. Undersized, big-hearted players at the collegiate level make the game special.
Well, Chris Kramer, to me, was a unique player. He could dominate a game at his size defensively.
Yep. He was the difference in that win against Texas A&M. Got them into the Sweet 16 last year. Morris is bumped by Lucas.
You get the sense that the backcourt size of Michigan is going to start to wear down Michigan State in this game with both Hardaway and Morris.
Lucas picks up his third, fourth team foul against Michigan State. Just over 6 minutes gone by here in the second half. Fitzmatrich, Bogrich, along with Novak, Hardaway, and Darius Morris, the five on the floor for Michigan. One thing the Spartans have not allowed is too many open looks for Novak. But Morris and Hardaway have found theirs. Trying to run a backdoor cut. Thornton well defended. Smotrich for three.
See, that's what that offense, when they're ahead, Tim, that's what the offense opens up, the back doors and then the kickouts.
Lucas answers. He's beginning to feel it. Play with a sense of purpose. This time of year, seniors know when to turn the light switch on. A steal by Kalen right on cue, and he's tripped. Well, that could be intentional, couldn't it, against Hardaway?
No, it's just a reach in and giveaway foul, but Appling doing a nice job defensively out front getting the pick.
I don't know if Tom feels that way. Take a look at this.
It's just a reach in and a trip.
Good call, Mike. You're right.
Yeah, no, he's in. But you can see now that the Michigan State's starting to amp up their defense, extend their pressure up the floor a little bit.
That's Gary Moeller over there, the former Michigan coach, sitting right behind Tom Izzo. All the dignitaries in the Michigan State rivalry are on hand. Ball is deflected, but it's recovered by Summers. Lucas has the last 9 points for Michigan State, and he pumps again. Green keeping it alive. Summers the putback. Green again. Human pogo sticks underneath in Green.
Wow, this is the war of attrition, and Michigan State doing a much better job of converting offensive rebounds into points in this half.
And the youngster Morris has been bothered a bit by some of this pressure. Lucas really in his kitchen. Ragging the dribbler.
Well, we talked about him offensively with that coming back from that injury. It's on the other end of the floor, too, that they've seen a huge jump. His ability to pressure.
Douglas hit those two big shots to ice the game at the Breslin Center. He can be a silent assassin from time to time. Not heard from, and then all of a sudden a factor. Rowe with the Green with the rejection. Two-man game to Summers. The left-hand leaner does not go. Izzo really needed that one.
Not a great decision.
Douglas rejected by Green again on the outlet. Lucas stop and go. Well, he short-armed that one but was fouled. A lot of running with not much production. Take that. And that. And we'll be back with more of that. That's coming up tonight in prime time in that 230th meeting between the two. Back on February the 9th, Mike Jaminski and I were there for that one. And what do you suppose, Mike, will be the big key in the return match tonight for the ACC championship and a number one seed in the ACC tournament?
Well, I think the North Carolina's front line has to be dominant, and Henson and Barnes and Zeller, and get a little bit of three-point shooting. But that three-point shooting is more critical for Duke. I think they have to shoot 40 to 45 plus in that game. Seth Curry could be the X factor like he was in the second half of the first game.
In the first meeting, you'll recall, Kyle Singler and Harrison Barnes sort of negated one another with their defense. Of those two, which, in your opinion, needs to have the better night in the second meeting?
Well, whoever is going to win the game, I mean, if Harrison Barnes continues to be, score as he will, that's going to be the Carolina's benefit. But Kyle Singler has had a little bit of a sluggish finish to the season.
He has.
If he comes out and plays with energy, I think that that's going to be a big key.
Yeah, special night for Special K and Jim Nance in prime time on CBS. Martins have cut it to six. Hardaway with a leaner. Oh, what a tough shot. Junior looking good.
See, at 6'5", he's got the ability to elevate over just about anybody that Michigan State has.
No points in the first half. 12. And we've not played 8-9 minutes yet of the second half. He's been on fire here in the second. And Teddy Valentine has a foul inside.
Well, here's the play. You just see it. It's at 6'5 with the long arms. It's funny. He's got such a different body type than his father.
Yep.
You know, Tim Sr., a very short, blocky, powerful guy. This guy's long and lanky, and he can really elevate.
Five times an NBA All-Star was Tim, who played at Texas El Paso. One of the really good guys, too, that played the college game as well as the pro game. Draymond Green lost it. Last touch by Smotrich. Michigan State will control it. Conventional wisdom suggests that this is a game that Michigan needs more than the Spartans. But at the same time, you realize, of course, Tom Izzo doesn't coach that way. He's desperate for any win he can get on the road.
This is a Final Four experienced team here. They're not going to go out and roll over in a game.
Nice move by Delvon Rowe.
Yeah, you have to understand he's a left-handed player, and if he can get that way, he's going to score more times than not. And he's had some real health issues, and that was a very explosive move for a guy who's got some knee issues.
And this is a Michigan State team that just could not practice together. We're not together during the summer. Kalen Lucas really couldn't work out at all during the summer months because of that tear to the Achilles. Out of bounds, it belongs to the Wolverines. So in many respects, even with the loss of Chris Allen and Corey Lucius, this is a club that is just now getting injury-free with many of its veteran players. Shot clock winding down. Morris not there. Rowe gets the rebound. Michigan State has scored, Mike, on five of their last six trips.
There's the look opposite again.
What a pass. What a find. Out of bounds. Last touch by Draymond Green.
And the impressive thing to me, Tim, is that they've been much more efficient in their half-court offenses. There haven't been a lot of runouts in that stretch.
Yeah.
So they really struggled in the first half.
Hardaway's been hot on this end of the floor of the second half. Kalen Lucas on the other end.
That's the second time that Draymond Green has fouled a three-point shooter.
On a closeout, yep. Not what you'd expect from a veteran. His third foul. All of them in this half. And Hardaway gets to the free throw line.
Well, here's the look. I mean, you just want a pressure, and that was with the lower body running through him.
Well, the youngster from Miami, Palmetto Senior High, has been in double figures 22 times in the 30 games he's played.
I asked John Beilein about having the son of pros. He's got three of them on this team.
Wednesday on Survivor, does the kookiest tribe member ever have what it takes to stay in the game? Don't miss a new Survivor Wednesday, only CBS.
And he said that he's been seamless. He has just come in and picked up the, you talked about the young guys pick up the offenses. He got it right from day one.
The thing about Beilein's teams is they operate with precision. That's what he got going at West Virginia with Missoula. All of those guys, many of whom were a part of that team. Deshaun Butler that went on to the Final Four with Hugs. And a foul spotted as Lucas was trying to get free. Jordan Morgan running through the pick, picks up his fourth. And again, Smotrich will be called upon. And that's the sixth team foul, so we'll be in the bonus the rest of the way.
Smotrich gave them a nice lift off the bench in the first half. 14 points for the Michigan bench in the first 20 minutes. And 3-1 zone now.
Kicked away by Morris.
This is the one in this zone. They had the most best effect when they put Draymond Green in the high post and let him be a passer.
Lucas again. Count it. A three ball. 52-47. He's all smiles.
And that's again nice kick out by Rowe that time. The post up and the look opposite.
14 in this half, 16 on the game for Kalen Lucas. see how these youngsters from Michigan respond to the challenge that the veteran Spartans have brought. Little stop and go by Morris, fouled by Rowe. Tell you, he's unafraid, isn't he?
No, I see right here, you get the post inside and then the kick out.
That's his third team from six.
And Kalen is all smiles afterwards.
He's been a different player in the second half, and you knew he would be.
You know, in a lot of ways, when you struggle your freshman year, Mike, it can really benefit you the second season, and it seems that's been the case for Morris.
Like I said, he felt early on in his freshman year that he was kind of standing around and he felt like he could do more with the ball in his hands. And John Beilein didn't immediately agree with him, but over time came to see the benefit of that. He's got 5 assists and 1 turnover in this game.
Yeah. And that's in keeping with his season best statistical data in terms of doling out dimes in the Big Ten. Draymond wanted to shoot, did not have the handle completely, and decided to drive, and there's a foul again. Inside, Rowe was making his move and push. That's the 4th on Delvon Rowe.
It's a subtle little thing on timing and catches, and I think if Green had handled that cleanly, he would have launched the 3, but that little fumble allowed the defense to get back to him.
At this stage of the game, Rowe has provided some punch to Izzo's team inside, and he's electing to keep him in there for the time being. He's a veteran player, so it appears that Izzo thinks that the game is on the line. He needs him out there. Tomorrow on CBS, the mayor of Cincinnati is going undercover. But how does the most recognizable person in the city keep from blowing his cover? All new Undercover Boss tomorrow, only CBS. Springer's no longer the mayor of Cincinnati, is he?
I was going to say, I would hope that your mayor wouldn't be able to pull that off. Or else it was due to low voter turnout.
Yes. Lucas Alina, baseline, and an over-the-back foul spotted.
Second consecutive play where they've gotten an over-the-back call.
Yep. Draymond Green picks up his 4th.
Here's the look, and what Draymond Green was arguing with Ted Valentine is he said, hey, I had my hands up in the air. I didn't push anything.
Boy, I don't know. I agree with Draymond.
And a lot of times what happens to him when you have your hands up in the air, that's where the referee is looking, and he doesn't see that lower body contact.
Yeah, and Teddy Valentine's one of the best in the business, but I think Draymond had a good point on that one.
Summers. He and Lucas now, with the 2 big guys with foul difficulty, need to be effective, and it's 56-50.
Well, and I think Tom Izzo's found a combination here with Appling and Lucas and Summers out on the perimeter. They've been very effective offensively.
First points this half for Darrell Summers. Well, what do you think they'd take it to the 10 each time with the 2 bigs with 4 fouls? Novak, not there.
Well, there's a problem is there's not a post-up player out there for Michigan right now. Lucas has not been able to do it off the drive.
Appling with the dump down to Rowe. And that's a push. He'll go against Novak.
We've reached the under 8 timeout. Michigan leads by 6.
Young and old enjoy the Michigan-Michigan State rivalry. Wolverines leading by 6, but Kalen Lucas says put his team in position, Mike.
Yeah, and he had a 1 of 5 first half, but he has come alive here in the second half, 4 of 8, a couple of 3s, 27 points in the first game. You knew that they weren't going to keep him down, but he has rebounded nicely, 16 points so far to this point in the game.
And 14 of those 16 coming in this half. In fact, 14 of the 25 scored by Michigan State belong to Enumero Uno, Lukey, as Coach Izzo would call him.
The real issue right now, Rowe and Draymond Green, both with 4 personal fouls. Can they hang in there for the next 7.5 minutes?
They've been outscored at the free throw line. Michigan State. They need every one of these freebies to go down. We're talking about those incredible freshmen, and certainly Morris Hardaway has had his fair share of freshman of the week honors. Tough in a league that has Sullinger at Ohio State to perhaps be a threat for freshman of the year, but I think they should have a separate category, I think, for players other than Sullinger, don't you think?
No, no question about it.
I think he's won the award something like 9 or 10 times this year.
He may very well be the player of the year.
No question.
Although Juwan Johnson has really had an incredible season as well.
Hardaway is fouled by Thornton. That's the second against Austin.
Michigan State foul on number 13, Austin Thornton. That's his second.
In fact, if you think about it, Mike, there's so much talk of number one seeds this time of year. Ohio State would seem to be the most complete of the teams that are garnering that kind of attention. That could be one whale of a matchup when you talk about post-up players against teams that don't have anyone to counter.
Kansas right there as well, too. Yep. I think those two, and probably Duke the shakiest right now.
Yep.
And we'll see,
Pittsburgh, maybe.
We'll see tonight if Duke goes in and gets a win in the Smith Center. That would be a strong statement.
Right. And probably Pittsburgh, having claimed already one half of the regular season crown in the Big East, would be the other.
And the thing is dangerous, they've always been tough defensively, but Pittsburgh's scoring the ball a lot better this year with Ashton Gibbs healthy.
Well, what a weekend that'll be at the Garden in New York, especially with St. John's relevant again, despite the loss to Seton Hall. Lucas giving it up. Draymond Green for three.
He'll do. He'll set the high screen instead of roll to the basket, follow behind. Very, very capable three-point shooter.
That would have been huge had it gone down. They've not been this close all game long. Green again disrupting it, almost getting the pilfer. This is as close as Michigan State's been in this half.
This is where Michigan now will get a little bit more deliberate, run some clock, make you defend for 30 seconds.
Hardaway over Appling. Summers the rebound. In so many respects, the way this game has gone for Izzo, he's got to be pretty happy his team is this close.
I wonder if they were going to score a point in the first 10 minutes of the game.
No question. And a turnover. Douglas started it with the deflection. And from three, he almost finished it. Vogrich gets the recycle. Hardaway from downtown. Off the back iron, and it's pulled down by Lucas. All the way, don't blink. Got the foul prior to the shot. Wave it off. What a finish by Lucas, though, huh?
So quick off the dribble, had everybody in full retreat.
Oh. You know, that should count just for beauty.
Both of those teams, Ben, both of these teams in the last few possessions have had good looks, especially from three, and have not been able to knock them down. Basket gets a little bit smaller in the last 5 minutes.
Appling taking a seat. Some of these players are gassed. The young ones, too. Vogrich and Smatrich take the seat. As Morgan has come back onto the floor with four fouls, as well as Novak. Kalen 81% at the free throw line on the season. Draymond Green, another one of the fatigued Spartans, takes a seat. And Derek Nix comes in for him. Pershing High School product.
You wonder if this is if Tom Izzo is just going to try to get these guys under the 4 minute mark for the next TV timeout.
You expend, don't you, Mike, a ton of energy when you're coming from double digits down. And they've been that much of this day.
And they've had a number of come-from-behind victories in this year. They've shown a real resilience. And you don't want to do that time and time again, but they've been able to bounce back.
No field goals for the Wolverines in the last 6 minutes. There's a pick and roll to Morgan from Hardaway.
This is, again, what Michigan can do in this offense. They can get you spread out. There's no post player out there. A nice screen and roll between Rice and Morgan and Hardaway and Morgan.
fourth set now for Lucas.
It's his show.
Stop and go and walk.
Oh, a push off. Got it with the elbow. Charge. It'll go the other way.
This is good. Again, Hardaway using his size and the good roll inside. The weak side defense a little bit sloppy that time for Michigan State.
That is four fouls now on Kalen Lucas, and he joins Green and Roll in that category. His third offensive foul of the afternoon. Hardaway, well defended by Apple.
Here you talk about ball security, strength with your hands. He had it that time as Appling was up in his chin.
Yeah, but also the foul through Hardaway using his size, staying with the play.
Summers for three. Oh, the iron unkind, but Green is there for the offensive rebound. Out of bounds off of Douglas.
Inbound, ball to Michigan State.
Here's the drive, and this is just staying with the play. Good initial defense by Appling, but once he came up, once Hardaway got it again, there was nothing he could do.
Morgan kicked it.
Michigan State holds onto it underneath their own hoop. Timeout, Wolverines. So much on the line for Beeline. It has been an uphill battle all afternoon for Michigan State, but still, with the help of Kalen Lucas, Mike, they're on the precipice of success. But whenever you're trying to get over that hump, you need to get shots at the basket at critical times.
Well, and I think the big key for Michigan going forward is going to be on the glass. Can they keep Michigan State away from second chance opportunities, which has been an issue in the second half? But Tim Hardaway Jr. really struggled in the first half, but has come alive here, staying with the play right there. You can see his body language change as each shot was dropping. He's a double-figure scorer for them. He has really been playing at a high level over the last month or so.
Michigan State has done a better job on the offensive boards, Mike. They've got 19 rebounds to 9. That's the difference in the second half, and it's kept alive a few opportunities for them with their poor perimeter shooting. And other than Lucas and Summers on occasion, they've not shot the ball particularly well. Green working inside the mismatch against Novak.
He really wants to post him up.
Skip pass again to Appling. Inside the row, the jump hook goes.
60-56.
Now see, they did a better job, Michigan, of closing out on that weak side shooter, but that left row wide open in the post.
You see the team foul story. Michigan in the double bonus with the help of those 10 team fouls committed by the Spartans. Nice look inside. Morris to Morgan.
Jordan Morgan really plays well in this offense. He's got a sense of when he can go to the rim and good interior passing.
You know, he's been pretty smart with four fouls, too. Freshman has done a nice job of handling the defensive end in foul difficulty. Lucas working on Douglas, couple of veteran Big Ten players. Green feeds roll again. Summers with the clock winding down. Out of bounds, last touch by Hardaway Jr.
Again, you make a miss, you play good defense for 32 seconds, and you can't come up with a missed shot.
Bobby, for the longtime Michigan play-by-play man, used to say, touchdown, Michigan! In the earlier meeting, the Wolverines had lost 11 in a row at Breslin Center. Earlier this season, Zach Novak had 19. But it was Michigan State's Kalen Lucas, much as today, leading the comeback. 27 on the day, but it was Stu Douglas that stirred the pot late. He had that big three to seal the deal, 61-57. And look how long it's been since they swept in this series.
1997. And Tim, the interesting thing to me is that Michigan had 10 threes in that game, only five here. But doing it in other ways, they only had 5 free throws made in that first game, 17 here, so they're getting to the line and they're scoring inside.
Izzo's team has done the number on the offensive boards in the second half. That's enabled his team to get back into it. They're leading in that statistical category 12-3, 7-1 this half.
I'll tell you what, Zach Novak is doing a terrific job of battling Draymond Green down low.
He is. Draymond, nice move there on Q. A little too hard off the window. And Rowe is fouled by Hardaway. Sort of a giveaway foul that time by 10. Really didn't need it. And the fourth foul on Tim Hardaway Jr.
Well, what Michigan has to talk about now is collectively rebounding the basketball. They've got to get 5 guys and come up with a possession after a miss. They're doing a good job on the initial defense, but too many second chances for Michigan State.
Keebler will come back onto the floor, replacing Kalen Lucas. And here is Rowe, a 66% free throw shooter with 1 and a bonus. And they've got a jump ball with the arrow to Michigan State. Well, they had made their last 8 free throws before that miss. And just that quickly, Kalen Lucas back in for Keebler. Offense for defense. And with 4 fouls, probably something that Tom will be doing quite a bit of with Kalen the rest of the way. Oh, that's a dangerous one, isn't it? Michigan went to sleep. And still a recycle. Yet another offensive rebound for the Spartans.
Now, this is like a football possession for Michigan State.
How many more opportunities can you give them? Green trying to win off the dribble. Lost it. Out of bounds to the Wolverines. Yet another missed opportunity for Tom Izzo's squad.
80 seconds that last possession. And Michigan very fortunate that no points came out of it.
Critical defensive sequence for Michigan State with just over 2 to play. It's a 2 possession game. Morris posting up, and the push will go against Atlin.
And Tom Izzo talked about it. They went through a stretch and they were losing games that they were not very good defensively, giving up 50% shooting. But they've gotten back to that gritty defense that he's been known for.
Second. Stepping to the line out is you do for your Wolverines is number 4, Darius Morris.
What a performance today by the super sub from Los Angeles. Tomorrow on 60 Minutes, the closest you could ever imagine getting to one of the most dangerous predators on earth. And you'll see it on 60 Minutes tomorrow, only CBS. Just one of the 2 of the offensive rebound with the arrow to Michigan.
That's just something that should not happen at this level. Have the shooter get an offensive rebound on a free throw. Just short-armed it, and it came right back to him. Nobody stepping in front of him. Appling late getting in.
That's only the second offensive rebound that Michigan's had this half. It comes at a critical time, leading 7. This could be a 4-point trip for the Wolverines.
Well, not only that, but it could be about 25 to 30 seconds off the clock.
That's right.
Trying to work Morris into the post.
Over Rowe. Pulled down by Draymond Green. And they're going to get a timeout. Tom Izzo wants to talk about it. With 1:36 remaining here in Ann Arbor. We'll be back. Check out the action, the excitement of March Madness on 4 different networks. You won't miss a basket. And it all begins March 13th with Selection Sunday, followed by the first 4 on True TV on Tuesday and Wednesday nights. And then the second and third rounds, which we used to call the first and second, will be on all 4 of those networks. And we welcome the collaborative effort from our friends at Turner Network Television, the Turner Sports people. We really look forward to a new beginning on the road to this year's Final Four.
Lucas off the pick from Rowe.
What a shot.
And Tom Izzo has designed a few plays out of timeouts, hasn't he?
Right, you know what? Coaches time plays, shooters make plays.
Yeah, absolutely. We'll be back.
Michigan State, let's go.
Let's take a look, Mike, at our Coke Zero impressive moment of the game. This was after a great Michigan State run. This pick and roll from Hardaway to Morgan, freshman to freshman, came at just the right time to stave off the Spartans.
Well, and what makes the play is that Hardaway had been on such a run shooting the basketball, you're forced to honor him, and that left Morgan wide open on the roll.
Still plenty of time before this one is decided. After that three-point play designed by Tom Izzo.
Well, if I'm Michigan right now, I want you want Novak handling the ball, 85% free throw shooter.
Thornton reaching in and gives himself up. And Hardaway will get to the free throw line. It's time to extend the game if you're Michigan State.
Yeah, Hardaway, the other option at 75%.
That's his third.
It's the third on Thornton.
And the line out is shooting.
And two coming up for Hardaway.
Hardaway Jr.
A lot of conversation, Mike, about the strength and power of the Big East. We saw Georgetown and Syracuse last week. I would submit to you that the Big East is so large that it's almost an unfair conversation any longer what conference is best. But top to bottom in a conventional league, this one's pretty good.
Well, real good. Yeah, and John Beilein told me before the game he thought this was as tough as he's ever seen it.
Yep. Lucas from downtown again. Roll over the back, that'll be fine. Draymond Green, I beg your pardon. And that'll be five on him.
Michigan State foul, number 23, Draymond Green. That's his fifth.
They had to go for it. He did.
And if you had to lose one of the two, you would have preferred Rowe, because Green does so many things for you on the offensive end. He's a playmaker. He's your shooter. That one really hurts.
If you recall last year in the Final Four against Butler, Green was in some foul difficulty and played a role in that game for Tom Izzo. He's just, I don't know if a more valued commodity in a big man playing an all-four game is Draymond Green.
Well, consider the fact, too, about Zach Novak at 6'4", fouling him out in this game and battling him down in the low block.
You would think it would go the other way, wouldn't you?
Yep.
This could be the statement game for the Wolverines. Remember, when they made the tournament a couple of years back, they began the season 3-4 in the Big Ten, managed to get to 9-9. This year, they began 1-6 and could end the year at 9-9. Orton has that one deflected by Novak. Hardaway with numbers, 3-on-2, back to the star. He missed the chippy. Thought he got fouled, and it leaves the door open for Lucas on the other end. That rainbow won't go. Loose ball pulled down by Morgan. He's fouled by Rowe, and that'll be his fifth. They can feel it in Ann Arbor.
Yeah, very fortunate. I thought that was a beautiful pass by Hardaway on the break. I was surprised that Novak didn't convert.
Yeah, he's upset with himself about it. Heartbreak Hotel for Kalen here.
Yeah, he's just had hands flying at him the whole time. Good hustle play by Morgan.
So Rowe leaves the game with 6 points. But he made a solid contribution in the second half. He really did. Now the status for the Spartans, one would think, is still awfully good. Largely, Mike, because of who they played non-conference. I know you were ranked preseason number 2. You've got a streak of 13 consecutive trips to the NCAAs, but when you play the likes of Syracuse and Duke and Kansas, it gives you a better resume at the end of the season. It does.
Well, it was the guy that they lost in the offseason, Chris Allen, and then I don't think that the pollsters factored in that Kalen Lucas was probably at about 50% at that point.
Absolutely.
You know, so there were a lot of injuries, and they were probably overvalued early on.
That being said, when they had Lucius before they lost him, when you think about it, Mike, there was a sort of Final Four swagger to this team that has since been lost, and Izzo is trying to find it before we get into the Big Ten tournament.
Well, it's always difficult when you're trying to find things at the end of the year.
No doubt.
It's not a good position to be in.
Lucas, the one good aspect for this Michigan State team is that he's getting healthy.
The Big Ten Player of the Year two seasons ago is working his way into shape. As you look at our game reset, Michigan does have the ball with a 5-point lead. So this one's still far from over. But a couple of Spartans, critical Spartans, have been lost due to fouls, both Delvon Rowe and Draymond Green. Stu Douglas will trigger it in. Well, obviously, Lucas doesn't want to commit his fifth. Appling will commit his foul, and one of those situations where precious seconds came off the clock because Kalen couldn't get himself up.
But Appling just about 8 seconds, Tim, as a result of that.
That's right.
Appling committing his third, putting Hardaway Jr. at the line.
Let's see, that's kind of the opposite. A lot of times, good defensive teams can funnel a guy who's a poor free throw shooter to get in the pass. That time, they got a guy covering the guy who couldn't commit a foul.
Coming up next, Villanova at Pittsburgh. Always a fun encounter. And tonight in primetime, Duke and North Carolina. They're feeling the tournament in Ann Arbor. 68-61. As you look at our game reset, Michigan State needs to convert, probably extend the game, and hope for some help at the free throw line for Michigan. But they've got to score quickly. A big, big moment for this Wolverines program. They can come away with a win. That's the last thing that John Beilein wanted from a veteran player like Douglas, to stop the clock and allow Lucas to get to the free throw line.
Well, and he was arguing with the referee, but you know, he should have never been in a position to do that. You never want to force people to make that. And again, you get that hand extended and moving, and Lucas getting the ball on the run.
21 points this half for Kalen Lucas.
Really, 1 second came off the clock.
Yeah, I mean, this is we talk about extending the game, that plays right into the hands of Michigan State. It's that old story, you have to learn how to finish. Play well, but you have to learn how to finish, and that's been
the last thing a young team does.
Yep. It's what happened to them in the game with Wisconsin as well. Morris doubled, lost it. Ted Valentine wants help, and he gets it. And the ball goes back to Michigan State. Terry Weimer, the official, came over to say, yep, out of bounds off of Morris. And I think they got it right. A hoop here, and it becomes a one possession game. Lucas wants it against Hardaway. Summers with the offensive rebound. Lucas stays with it. Now a scrum underneath, out of bounds to Michigan.
A couple opportunities, but you didn't have your bigs in there as finishers.
Yep.
Yeah, off of his knee. Good call.
Morris splitting the double team. Again behind the back. How about a coronation? Thank you. That's the way to put a period on it at home in the regular season for Michigan. Hardaway Jr., the star of the game, goes end-to-end to close it out. 20 for him. What a performance.
There's the look, and Morris. Morris just doing a nice job.
How about that?
Our final score is 70-63. For Mike Jaminski, Tim Brando saying so long from Ann Arbor, Michigan. Villanova and Pittsburgh, plus Duke and North Carolina in primetime tonight. This has been a presentation of CBS Sports on our 30th road to the Final Four.